Okay, good morning students. We will continue with the question number 11. What is question number 11? Find the number of ratio of the consonants to number of vowels in the word mathematics. So mathematics has got how many letters? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 letter word is mathematics. Vowels are A, E, I, O, U. So, rest of them are called consonants. The letters other than vowels are called consonants. So, ratio of consonants to vowels. How many are there? There are one, underlined one are vowels. So, there are four vowels. So, consonants are total 11. 11 minus 4. How much it is? 8. So, 8 ratio, there are 4. Isn't it? No. 7 ratio 4. So 11 minus this one is 7. So 7 ratio 4. Okay. Because A, E, I, O, U are vowels. So rest are consonants. Okay. So now in a garment shop, 5 by 13 of people are males. Find the ratio of females to males. So, you had to find the ratio of females to males. How many females are there to males? 5 by 13. So, rest are females. So, how many females are there? 13 minus 5. That is 8. So, males equals 5 by 13. Females will be 13 minus 5 upon 13, that is 8 by 13. So, ratio of females to males. Ratio of females to males equals, first is females. So, 8 by 13 upon 5 by 13. So, that is 8 ratio 5. 8 ratio 5 is the answer for this question. Okay. 8 ratio 5. Now, next one is divide rupees 560 between A and B. There are two persons, A and B. Between them, you had to divide in the ratio 3 is to 2. So, 3 is to 2 is the ratio given where 560 has to be divided. So, total parts 3 plus 2. How many are the total is, that is 3 ratio 2. It has to be divided. Rupees 560 has to be divided. So, this is A ratio B. Isn't it? Now, total parts. Out of 5, A has got 3 parts. So, total parts is, total parts equals 3 plus 2, that is 5. So, what is part of A? A has got 3 upon 5 part. So, it has to be divided. That means 560 rupees has to be divided. So, out of 3 by 5 is a fraction of 560. So, you will cancel. This is 1, 1, 2. 1, 1, 2 into 3 is 3, 2s are 6. 3, 1s are 3. 3, 1s are 3. So, A got how much rupees? 336. So, what about B? There is no need to find B because you can directly subtract 560 minus 336 will give you, this is 4, 5 minus 3 is 2 and 5 minus 3 is 2, 2, 2, 4. Or else you can do out of 2 by 5, 2 by 5 part into 560. So, it is 1, 1, 2, 1, 1, 2 into 2, 2, 2, 4. So, you got it as A ratio B, that is A got how much rupees 336 and B got how much rupees 224. So, total both should give 560 rupees. If you add 336 and 224, you will get 560. So, you got how much? That is when the ratio is given, the total parts, what fraction of this one? That is 3 ratio 2 if it is, total parts is 5. Out of that, one got 3 by 5 and the other got this one. Next is, two people invested 15,000 and 25,000 to start a business. Decide to share profits in the ratio of their investment. Ratio of the investment. What is the investment? Their investment is investment of A and B are 15,000 and 25,000. So ratio of investment, how much it is? 15 cancels, that is 3:5, isn't it? They are in the ratio 3:5. So they decided to share the profit in this ratio. So first one got out of 8, isn't it? Total parts is 8. Out of 8 they got 3 and the other got out of 8 5. Now if their profit is 12,000, that means like the previous question, rupees 560 divided among 2 in the ratio 3:2, same here 12,000 should be divided among the ratio 3:5. So 12,000 in the, so how much each get? The profit, profit of first person, that is here I have written A, that is equal to 3 upon total is 8 into 12,000. How did you get 8? Because it is in the ratio 3:5. So upon 8 means how much? It is 1 time 440, it is 500. So it is rupees 4,500. First one got 4,500. Next it will be how much? 12,000 minus 4,500. That can be. So profit of the second one. Profit of second equals two method. Either you can write 5/8 into 1000, this one, that is 5/8 into 12,000. 12,000 cancels means 1500. 1500 into this one is rupees 7500. So both of them got how much? One is rupees 4500. First one got as rupees 4500. And second one got it as rupees 7500. So first got it as rupees 4500 and second got it as rupees 7500 because they are in the ratio 3:5. So this is the answer. Okay. Students, the next question is, the ratio of Angus money to Roma's money is 9:11. So Ankur and Roma is dividing their money in the ratio 9:11. If Ankur has rupees 540, how much has Roma has? How will you find? That means 9 part is equal to 540. So what about 11 part? There is this equivalent ratio. So 9/11 equals to 540. That way you can find. So Ankur's money, ratio of Ankur's money to Roma's. What is the ratio given? Ratio given is 9:11. 9:11. So what about, that is 9/11 if you put it in fraction. Now if Ankur has rupees 540, that means Ankur has 9/11. That is equal to 540 upon x. You have to find x. X is money Roma has. Money Roma has equal to x. So let money Roma has, that is equal to x, I am considering. So 9/11 equal to 540 upon x. So how will you find x? See, what is this? 9 into how much is 9? You know the tables. 9 5s are 45, 9 6 54. So this is, if I multiply it with into 60, here I had to multiply 60, isn't it? So 540 upon 9, it is 60. So this one. So what is 11 into this one? 6 into 11 is 660. So x is equal to 660. So how much money Roma has? Roma has rupees 660. Isn't it? Roma has, the money Roma has, that is equivalent ratio. Here it is 9/11 equal to 540 upon 660. Now next one is, ratio of weights of tin and zinc in an alloy is 2:5. How much zinc is there in 31.5 grams of alloy? Alloy is a mixture of two different substances. So here we have got two substances. One is tin and another is zinc. So if they are mixed, that is called an alloy. Like tin, gold and silver can be mixed, or else iron and tin, or else iron and copper. Okay, copper and zinc, anything can be mixed to form an alloy. Here, that is, they are mixed in the ratio 2:2. So here, ratio of weights of tin and zinc. What is the ratio of weights? They are 2:5. So what is zinc? How much zinc is there? So zinc, part of zinc in alloy is 2/7. How much is the total weight of alloy given? It is 31.5. Part of this one, tin and zinc, it is 5/7. 2/7 is tin. So here, as you cancel this one, 5. So it is 5 5s are 25, balance to 5 4s are 20, 22.5 grams of zinc is there. So how much zinc is there in the alloy? In the total alloy, the zinc is 22.5 grams of zinc is there. That means alloy is a combination of different metals. Here the metals are used, tin and zinc. So they are in the ratio. That means if I take 200 grams of tin, then I should take 500 grams of zinc. So among the total 7 parts, 2 parts are of tin and 5 parts are of zinc. So total parts is 5/7 of zinc. The total grams, how many grams of alloy is there? 31.5. So 5/7 into 31.5. Hope you understood the question. Okay.